everyone knows that ChatGPT, OpenAI's chatbot, is absolutely amazing. But few know that research scientists have some new tricks to unlock even more capabilities in it. And some of these ideas sound almost like a science fiction movie. And they work. Dear fellow scholars, this is 2-Minute Papers with Dr. Károly Zsolnai Fehér. So, what does that mean? Well, from an earlier paper, we know that we can create 25 copies of ChatGPT, tell them that they are characters with a given backstory, for instance, a scientist, and they will actually think that they are that person and play in this virtual world as if they were that person. They were even able to organize a Valentine's Day party among themselves. But they can also create a game development company that has its own CEO, developers, testers, and managers who work together. Which is pretty crazy if you think about the fact that this is just copies of the same ChatGPT, copies of the same brain, if you will, but customized for different tasks. So, is that efficient? Well, they can really work together. A developer can hand off a task to a tester, while other AI copies could play it as a new player would and write up a good piece of documentation for it. And they created a video game with a total budget of, get this, $1. Absolutely amazing. You see, with this amazing AI and a little creativity, absolute miracles can be done with it. And here are some newer ones. This one just came out and it is absolutely insane. An AI hospital. Yes, you heard it right. Once again, every character here is played by ChatGPT. Patients, nurses, doctors, all AIs. If someone falls ill, they have to register, then they get a consultation, a diagnosis is being made, a treatment is proposed, and his recovery will be monitored over time. So much so that these AI doctors get to do this 10,000 times, which would take years and years of practice for a real doctor. But here is our question. Why? Why do all this? Is this just a fun project, or does this help improving an AI's medical knowledge? Well, look at that. It does indeed improve over time. Fantastic! But now, one more question. Does it improve it in any meaningful way? How does it compare to competitors and the GPT-4 AI it is built on? Could it possibly surpass those? Oh, my goodness! When it comes to diagnosing and treating respiratory diseases, it beats everything. It is the best AI out there on the respiratory disease part of the MedQA benchmark. The regular GPT-4 is about 84% accurate on this dataset, derivative works built on it go up to about 90%, and this one 93%. That is absolutely incredible! And it sounds like something that came right out of a science fiction movie. And all this by playing a video game with itself. Loving it! I will add here as a disclaimer that this does not mean that such a technique could or should replace a doctor. Not at all. After every similar study, we find that these tests have their limits and a practical person-to-person visit at a hospital is always a little different than these. However, these could be, and hopefully will be, super helpful for real doctors who do real work and save more lives than they otherwise could. Absolutely amazing! But we are not done yet, not even close. Scientists also tried this concept on translating literary texts. Wait, is that a tough challenge? Why? Well, it is, because for this, you have to understand not only the language, but you also have to understand the culture in which these were written for, and we haven't even talked about the crazy, figurative expressions that you might encounter. They, once again, have copies of ChatGPT, some of them are being told to be editors, translators, and proofreaders. They work together according to a tightly defined algorithm. And the result is, once again, stunning. It not only improves on the base GPT-4 AI that it is built on, but it can also translate not just what it sees, but it understands what it means in its cultural context. And that is the hard part. These research works feel like they are straight out of a science fiction movie, and yet here we are in the age of AI, where these research papers can help us be healthier, live longer, read the works of masters from a previous era, or just write a cool video game for us. This is all possible today. What a time to be alive! If you're looking for inexpensive cloud GPUs for AI, Lambda now offers the best prices in the world for GPU cloud compute. No commitments or negotiation required. Just sign up and launch an instance. And hold on to your papers, because with the Lambda GPU Cloud, you can now get on-demand H100 instances, and they are one of the first cloud providers to offer publicly available on-demand H100 access. Did I mention they also offer persistent storage? So join researchers at organizations like Apple, MIT, and Caltech in using Lambda Cloud instances, workstations, or servers. Make sure to go to lambdalabs.com/papers to sign up for one of their amazing GPU instances today.